The simplest way of putting what we're doing here with the Alpine Plus project is that we're reusing carbon waste that's already above the ground, and we're turning it into saleable products like ethanol, sustainable fuels, fabrics, products that you're using every day. Rather than using carbon that's still below the ground, and you know, we can leave that where it belongs. My name is Kurt Studebaker. I'm a senior global services advisor with LanzaTech, and I'm their chief here on site for the Alpine Plus project. For the Alpine Plus project, the primary feedstocks are going to be forestry residues and municipal solid waste off-gas. So these processes are already in motion, generating other products that we use every day. But these gases can be fed through the LanzaTech process and used to make other saleable products and reduce these carbon emissions to the atmosphere.
Think of LanzaTech's carbon recycling technology like retrofitting a brewery into an emission source like a steel mill or a landfill site. Instead of using sugars and yeast to make beer, pollution is converted by bacteria to make ethanol, which you can then use to do everything from making clothing to making sustainable aviation fuel.
My name is Mark Gorenson. I'm a technology development lead here at Suncor in the renewable liquid fuels department. LanzaTech is a world leader in carbon recycling, and Suncor makes a conscious effort to partner with leaders in their field. And so with LanzaTech's experience in carbon recycling and Suncor's broad experience in operating and our extensive fuel network within Canada, it makes a great fit for the project. And leveraging our existing footprint in Alberta really allows us to efficiently test and develop this technology right here in Alberta.
ERA's investment in this project was $10 million through LanzaTech, which was then supplemented by Suncor.